let's find out who today's mascot of the day is. Slot machine.
All right, what do we got?
Please.
Who do we got?
Oh, that would be Nordy.
Nordy. Very nice.
Hey, wave Nordy. That flag.
Aptly named because he hails from the
North.
The North.
Iron Range in Minnesota, even. He does a great job. Would you believe, EJ, there's like a whole college for these mascots. They go to college.
Yes, I didn't know that.
There's like a whole educational institution around this whole concept of mascots. And I'll tell you what, they add a lot. You ask anybody 7 years of age and under inside an NHL venue, they're talking about the fluffy characters patrol the bleachers, the stands in and around NHL arenas.
Right.
They bring a lot. They bring a lot to the entertainment value in a game.
Yeah, now we're looking at the profile of Nordy here, 6'6". None of the mascots like to put their weight out there. They
kind
all
of
have
a sore
some
subject.
Sort of,
kind of
yeah.
a sore
and
subject.
And none of them like to talk about that. But he was found skating the frozen lakes and ponds. And look, I mean, We've got an inside source.
You know what? He is kind of a ladies' man, Nordy. Coincidental, he gets honored today because, I don't know if you know, yesterday was Betty White's birthday, 97 years of age. Nordy dated Betty White.
Oh, wow.
For a couple of weeks. It was a while ago now.
So it was kind of like a coincidental.
Yeah,
wow.
Yeah.
Right.
That's amazing. Where can I find this information?
We can talk. Look at
on the off chance I wanted to verify that.
We'll get into that later.
Look who is joining us now.
We can try to verify this information our very own Jamie Hersch, who is joining the show from Minnesota. Jamie, is there any truth to this fake news from EJ Raddick that Nordy dated Betty White? I'm not buying
it. That's a new one for me, but I think
homework.
I'm going to have to ask Nordy himself. Because I thought that we had a special thing going, so I'm going to have to ask him myself.
Yeah.
But no, I'm actually coming to you guys live from the North Woods, the Iron Range of Minnesota, which is apparently the birthplace of Nordy. And right behind me, there's a Minnetonka High School boys team. They're the number one ranked boys team right now in the state of hockey. So they're kind of a big deal. They're going to be taking on the number two ranked team tomorrow in this great event that happens every year. It's sponsored by the Minnesota Wild. It's called Hockey Day Minnesota. And every year they go to a different part of Minnesota and they play three outdoor games. So last year, I know I joined you guys from St. Cloud where we covered the event last year. That's what I think you're seeing right now. And I mean, it's just been really fun out here in Bemidji, especially. The whole community gets behind this. It's a huge effort. And then, like I said, there's two different high school boys hockey games tomorrow and a college women's hockey game as well. I will tell you, it was not this cold last year. I did not know what I was getting into. It was like 40 degrees last year, and I just had a little leather jacket on. It is -5 real temperature right now, you guys. And Jackie, that's Fahrenheit.
I was going to say.
I don't know what that is, Celsius.
That Celsius is really bad, gotta be like minus 25 probably.
Yeah. Jamie, it feels like -20 right now. I don't know how that's a real, like how you measure that, but I can measure it by just telling you it's not pleasant, but we're going to play hockey tomorrow.
That will go down as your Herschelian feat of this broadcast.
That's right.
You are doing an interview in -4 weather, that's your Herschelian feat for the day. Take the rest of the day off.
I'll take it. No, it's just a fun event to be here. And I mean, as you guys obviously know, and probably a lot of our viewers know, I'm a very proud and vocal Minnesotan. And so to be back here in my home state covering an annual hockey holiday really is just a dream come true. So it's really fun. And I'm just glad to shine the spotlight on this great effort the Minnesota Wild puts on every year.
So, Jamie, give us the rundown of what you're going to be doing over the course of the weekend. Can fans see more of this on NHL Network over the next couple of days?
Not specifically on NHL Network, but I know that Fox Sports North is what the team is, the network that covers the Minnesota Wild. It's where I used to work, actually. And I'll be hosting the whole event starting at 10:30 a.m. Eastern tomorrow, 9:30 Central, and we go all the way through till the Wild game starts at 9 o'clock Eastern PM. So it's going to be a day of hockey and really a lot of fun. But I think Fox Sports Go is a place that you can watch it. It's on an app, and so everyone in Minnesota, of course, can tune into Fox Sports North. But yeah, I'll of course be documenting it on social media and everything too. So it should be a really special event.
So you have the setup there with the rink behind you there. Are they going to just be playing continuous games now around the clock for the next 48 hours?
So they actually are. There's a ton of events going on. Last night, there was a game here on this ice that they built. We're on the south shores of Lake Bemidji itself, which is this massive lake. Tonight, Michigan Tech is actually playing the Bemidji State men's hockey team in a game at 7 o'clock Central. And then tomorrow, again, the two high school boys games, the women's college game. And I think then that's the final game of the weekend. But really, I mean, it's amazing how the community comes together and puts this whole thing on, because there's a whole village with bonfire pits and there'll be hot chocolate trucks and everything. So people are going to do their best to stay warm. I talked to one guy who has three different sweaters and long underwear layers on, and then a heated vest, like a battery powered heated vest, and then two coats and multiple hats and everything. I was like, wow, you came prepared. So that's the way that Minnesotans deal with the winter and prepare for hockey. So it's admirable.
Jamie, I'm peeking over your shoulder, reminiscing. I took part in a lot of scenes like that as a young boy. It was leave school, go home, park the books, grab your skates, head back to the outdoor rink. How pervasive is that in the great state of Minnesota? I mean, it would seem to me, like Canada, where I grew up, outdoor hockey on ponds and artificial rinks all over the place, going on morning, noon, and night statewide. Fair to say?
Yeah, it really is everywhere. And, you know, we like to call it the state of hockey, and that's because of things like this, where people, you know, they don't care what the temperature is. People want to be outside playing hockey, watching hockey, enjoying it. And it is very pervasive throughout the state of people just grabbing the skates and going out there. And, you know, nobody here has complained about it being so cold, which is really amazing to me. I'm the soft New Jersey resident now that's sitting here saying, what is this? But everyone out here just loves it. And it's so much fun. And I think, you know, it's represented by the fact that 57 Minnesota born players actually played in an NHL game last year. It's the most Minnesota players that had ever played in an NHL season. And so that just gives you an idea of how many players around the National Hockey League do hail from the state of hockey. So it's growing. The girls game is growing stronger and stronger each year, by far has the most participants of any state in the U.S. And so it's just nice to see that even though it's a big deal, it always has been a big deal to us, like it's still continuing to grow. So yeah, it's a fun thing to be a part of for sure.
Don't feel bad, Jamie. It's going to be 8 degrees here on Sunday night in New Jersey. So welcome
back. That's a heat wave.
All right, well, listen, Jamie, it sounds like it's going to be an incredible time tomorrow. Go get warm, and thanks for hanging out with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you, guys. And thanks for shining the spotlight on Nordy. I will get back to you.
On Betty White.
Yeah, it's out there. Yeah. Just do your homework. You'll find out.